Well, I'm back for another episode, and as you can see, I did find some diamonds. And I have a flint and steel, and I have some obsidian. What can it mean? Well, today we're off to the nether. We're going to have a quick. I'm going to show you what a few differences in there. But the main thing we're looking for is gold. Oh, so the lightstone dust. With that, we're going to be able to make the Philosopher's Stone, and with that, we'll be able to convert one value of an item into the same value of another item, or a combination of items. So it really is very useful for getting started, and that's why I'm doing it in such an early episode. So we're going to have a look at that. It's called an equivalent exchange. But first of all, we're going to have a look through this portal. Now the main difference in here is the ores. So I'm going to show you what you can look for. Let's see. Okay, we're pretty safe. Safe-ish. Let's see if we can see any ores around. Now, mining in the Nether isn't exactly safe. So I'm led to believe, and haven't tried it. But apart from the glowstone, if there's any pigmen around, they will be attracted and attack you. So here you can see that's the kind of stuff you're looking for. That's probably coal. Can't see any pigmen around. Let's have a look at this. Okay, nether coal. So that's the difference in the nether rocks that have ore in them. There's not that much difference in visual looks, but hopefully that'll give you a clue as to what to look out for. Right, well, got glowstone right beside me. I'm going to grab this and head back to the base. I'll see you there. Okay, well, made it back with those items, and here's the recipe for the Philosopher's Stone. It's quite an expensive one, but you'll never want for diamonds. Okay, right. Here it is. Some cool things it can do. It can convert items between values, like this wall here. So it just converts cobblestone to smooth stone, or smooth stone to cobblestone. I'm going to tidy up my room now. If I hold down V, you can see the Philosopher's Stone charging up. Kaboom! That's why I'm never too fussed about using cobblestone and then tidying up later. Okay, there are other settings for this. You can do lines and various ways to optimize it, but yeah, I'll let you have a look at the wiki for all that kind of stuff. But that's one of the cool things it can do. I really like that. I'm not gonna, I mean, as I said, I'm not gonna spawn items into the game, but I'm gonna use items available within the game to make my life easier as part of this mod pack, and that includes the Philosopher's Stone and equivalent exchange. It does make your life a lot easier. Certainly now we're at a point where we're wanting, well, you'll have noticed if you've built this setup that it isn't really isn't that efficient. You feel like you're losing some power from here. The coal just doesn't cut it. It works, but it's not fantastic. And what we're going to be doing next is setting up some more powerful energy devices to power more devices down here. And that's, I'm going to base that on solar energy. I'm also going to be interested in having high-powered storage devices so that the solar energy can charge that up during the day and it'll run through the night. And if it's raining or if there's snow outside, you know, we still have that big reserve of energy to fall back on. So I'm going to do that in the next episode. This episode, though, is all about the Philosopher's Stone. So you've seen one of the things it can do. It can also convert grass to sand. There we are. Oh, those mobs outside are confused. It sounds like I've got rats running around in my ceiling. I've built this bit underground, and it's to give me sort of plenty of room to build things in. Yeah, all of these items are industrial craft, and build craft allows you to automate things. So we'd be able to pump items from the chest into our grinder, followed by our macerator, then the furnace, and then pump the items back out at the end to another chest. So automating the process. So that's why I've built this big room. It's all underneath my unfinished house. My house upstairs doesn't look all that much, and that's why I've got rats moved in. Anyway, right, next thing we want to do is create a tablet. It's called Transmutation Tablet. And here's the recipe. So I took the opportunity to cook up a few bits of stone to get this created. There's our tablet. You get the Philosopher's Stone back. Okay, let's put this down somewhere useful. Okay, so it takes up quarter of a slab. You can place it on top of items. That's what I'm doing. Okay, so now what we do is we teach it about items. Now, before you use any items up completely, make sure you've put it once inside this transmutation tablet, and then it learns what it's capable of making. So let's teach it about glowstone dust. You sort of came up with learned. Okay, let's teach it about redstone. Okay, it's learned about redstone. Let's see what it does now. Well, we can convert glowstone into redstone. Now, that's an EMC value of 384. Redstone is a value of 64, which means we should be able to get this value up to just over 364. So 384 allows us to convert redstone into glowstone. Quite an expensive process. I'm more interested in converting the glowstone to redstone, to be honest with you. But that's those two items learnt. What else? This is something you're going to find quite useful. Certainly getting started when you haven't got too many items. Right, so that was quite a high EMC value. Let's learn about gold. Quite a high EMC value for gold. Four golds, make a diamond. Okay, so before you use up any items in the game, put them in here, teach it, and you will find it very useful. You'll always be able to create an item even if you've run out and you're in a hurry to get it. Okay, here's one of the things I like to do with it. Getting sand is so slow, but you always have a lot of dirt. Let's teach it the dirt, teach it the sand, and then we'll just convert all the dirt to sand. Very useful. So this is how I end up getting quite a lot of sand for glass, and you'll need a lot of glass as we start on build craft and working on oil wells and all that kind of stuff. All the pipes to do with build craft use glass in them. So that's a handy little recipe there to know. Okay, well, that's it, guys. Philosopher's Stone, the transmutation table, it's all part of equivalent exchange. You can look up other things, but they're the main things. like I said, I'm not going to be too fussed about using this. As far as I'm concerned, it's part of the game because it's part of the mod pack that I'm using. So I will be using it as and when needed to generate items to be able to build faster from, you know, I've managed to gather a lot of resources just by mining so far. And being able to convert from one item to another type. Let's see, what does this come up at all? Oh, it does. Well, that's handy. Okay, some of the items don't show up in here because they don't have any AMC value. But I seem to be able to click anything in there at the moment. Okay, there's a reason why I'm doing tin and gold dust. You are sometimes going to want them. And that's for next episode. Alright, thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you next time.